fun, isn't it? You make me happy, the Proclaimers. And I'll tell you who does make me happy. A1. Oh. Yeah, do you see what I did? They're in, they're back. Paul, Christian, Mark and Ben. So it's 20th anniversary. Let me move this so I can actually see you. It's 20th anniversary. Mm. Heady times, I would imagine. 1999.
Yeah.
Was the big year.
We're actually always sort of thought as a 90s band, but we really just released our first single in 99.
Yeah, we had a few months of being a band in the 90s.
Yeah.
But we're the 90s band.
Yeah. Any kind of acclaim is good, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, yeah.
And it was huge. That 3 years when you were all together was absolutely... Mm. You sort of took over, didn't you? Did it change you radically, do you think? Did you learn from it?
Well, Paul became very big-headed, didn't you?
Oh, he's so big-headed.
Oh, bless him.
not really. I think it's more people around you that change than yourself, because they start treating you differently or thinking that you want to be treated differently.
Yeah.
And then, I was 16 years old and came straight out of school. So all of my school friends were still...
I actually can't imagine that at 16.
It was crazy, yeah.
Yeah.
It was mad. But they were obviously all doing their A-levels and stuff, and I was busy with these guys traveling the world. So,
did you grow up very quickly?
I don't think I've grown up now. I think this was stumped my growth.
We were in a bit of a bubble, to be honest with you. It all just happened very quickly. It's one of those things that you hear a lot of bands say, that it's so nice to have another chance to do it so we can actually take the time to appreciate it. And, you know, looking back, it almost feels like another person. When I see our old videos, you know, Take On Me, and it doesn't feel like it's me, strangely.
I agree with that.
Yeah, it just Definitely. Feels like this guy on TV. I don't know if you can relate to that. So it's just a weird thing when you watch old videos from back in the day.
I just find it really upsetting. Time is a cruel mistress, that's all I can tell you about it. So how are you going to celebrate the 20th anniversary? What are you going to do? What are the plans?
Well, I think we're hoping to, obviously come back and do some concerts in the UK. I think a lot of people... We weren't actually going to announce that we were coming back as a four-piece in the UK until next year, but, you know, such is social media.
Bit late now.
Yeah, well, I know, exactly, but, you know, we were obviously doing these concerts in Asia, and we obviously had to do some promotion for that, and we weren't going to do a big announcement in the UK till we actually had some dates to announce. But anyway, that sort of all that plan went out of the window when we did put it on Twitter, and then all the papers started picking up on it. So we're a little bit premature, if I'm honest, with the news of coming back.
We've got solid dates. We've got solid plans, not solid dates.
Back in the studio, do more recording?
Absolutely. Later on today, in fact, we've got a new song that we're very excited about.
So this is kind of a warm-up for you then?
A little bit, yeah. Thank you.
Do you know what we have in common?
Quite a lot, I think.
But here's the thing. We both come second in the Eurovision Song Contest. Only one of us for Britain, though, may I say. So you represented Norway, didn't you?
We did. Yeah.
Oh, we've got to get our Norwegian member to answer this.
I'm Norwegian.
Yes.
And so I don't know how it came about, actually. I don't remember now, but we ended up entering into the Norwegian Eurovision final.
Yeah.
And we came second. And I've actually, because I've written a few songs for Eurovision in Norway before. I've actually come second four times now. So I'm hoping one of these days we'll be number one as well.
She'll be number one.
And we have another thing in common.
We have another thing. I was about to say this, because you were the original Marius in Norway.
Well, in 2009, I did Marius in Les Mis in the Norwegian West End production. I did, you know, it's over 100 shows, and it was really good fun.
Did you enjoy it?
I enjoyed it so much.
Obviously, and did you sing it in Norwegian?
I sang it in Norwegian.
So could you do Empty Chairs and Empty Tables? Now my friends are dead and gone. How does that sound in Norwegian?
Tomme bord og tomme stoler. That means empty chairs and empty tables.
Tomme stoler.
So romantic.
Yeah, it means the same, but it doesn't sound
quite the same.
And it's funny, it's 9 years ago now, and I don't remember most of the words, but I do remember that.
Yeah, it was 32 years ago.
Out of all the musicals I could have done, it was my favorite ever, you know, growing up and watching it. And
It's a good show.
It's such a great show, and an honor to follow in your footsteps.
Oh, if we're talking of musicals, Ben, I came to see, quite surprisingly, a musical that you'd written at the Other Palace, a sort of tryout theatre for the West End in London, of Eugenius.
Yeah.
It's called, this music. And I had one of the best nights in the theatre. It was lovely. So tell us about this musical.
Yeah, well, I mean, I've always loved musicals.
You're touring Footloose. You've been touring.
I'm doing Flashdance. Don't worry, everyone gets it wrong.
Oh,
my mum
so
still
sorry.
calls me and says, how's Footloose? I go, I don't know. Doing Flashdance. So it's, actually, it's fine that you say that. But no, I've always loved musicals. I go and see everything. And my my friend and I, who's a scriptwriter, would always come away from musicals and sort of discuss about what we would do differently if we were to have written it. And we thought, well, let's not just keep wishing that we, you know, we're watching different musicals. Let's write one ourselves. So we went to the pub in Clapham and had lots of beer and went home and thought, right, let's start one now. And that's why it's quite crazy and bonkers, and I think you can probably vouch
for
that fact.
Here's the thing, because I'm a superhero nerd. Right. I collect graphic novels, I go to all of the movies, you know, I love a superhero. And that's the basis, you know, well, the people, they're superhero nerds.
Exactly, yeah. I mean, it's about a young guy from America who writes comic books, and it's all about superheroes, and his superhero comic books come to Earth and come to life, and it all just goes absolutely bonkers. But it really is like the best time. I think, you know, a lot of critics were saying it's the best 2 hours that you could possibly think of a theatre.
It's great. It's great fun.
And it's going back on again. So
that's why I'm here.
So on the 1st of September, it opens back at the Other Palace, and I think we're one of the only shows that have ever been invited back because it did so well the first time around. So we're absolutely buzzing about that. And yeah.
Well, and here's the thing. New talent is the lifeblood of the theatre, and for you to be writing a new musical and for it to be working, I'm so pleased and proud for you.
Thank you.
It really is great. So if you get a chance, go and see that, The Other Palace. And also, boys, I can't wait to hear new stuff. Can't wait for you to be back doing this properly when it's officially announced.
Yes. Yeah.
Because we'll keep it just between us.
No one needs to know. Thanks for not telling me.
I do want to apologise to all the UK fans, because they've been getting on at us on Twitter and social media saying that you keep announcing all these Asian dates and stuff, and don't forget us. We haven't. We just want to say we absolutely love and truly appreciate all your support over the years.
I was wondering what you're going to apologise for.
I'm not going to apologise.
Sorry. Everyone enjoyed themselves. So it's lovely to do, and nice to have you back.
Thank you very much.
Back
it's great
time
to be back.
As well. Yeah, look after him, won't you?
Oh, we will.
Oh no, things are going very well. Ben just pinched his bum, so I think it's all going very well.
Absolutely. We're rebonding.
That's how it all started, I heard. Good boy. What are you going to sing for us?
Well, we're going to do another Norwegian thing.
See, you're overtaking the whole thing.
I'm taking over the Norwegians, I'm telling you. But we did, back in the day, our manager was asking, we need to do a cover of something. He said, did any Norwegian bands ever make it big? And obviously there's Aha.
Yeah.
It was only really Aha back
then.
Aha.
And Lord.
And no, so we did our first ever cover. It was a song called Take On Me.
That was beautiful. And actually, you outsold them, didn't you?
I know.
You got Aha, to number one with it.
Yeah, Aha was only number two with it in the UK, so we brought it where it belongs, at number one.
It's a great song, and you do it. Those notes, yeah, fabulous. Good luck.
Thank you.
Those notes, they're really tricky. Good luck.
Yeah.
Thanks.
No, they are.
Yeah,
they
no,
are
they? Well, it's quite high, isn't
yeah,
it? Feel free to jump in.
Not
if you...
a chance on this earth. Enjoy. Thanks for being here, boys.
Thanks.
We hope you're going to join in at home.
Blimey!
There you go.
You don't get many of them to the pound, do you? That's
apologies to people at home that are still asleep. Yeah, I've just remembered it is Sunday and I'm screaming down their radios.
I don't think it was screaming. It was very, very beautifully controlled, actually, Ben. No,
thank
that
you.
Sounded smashing. Best of luck with the recording this afternoon and look forward to hearing the new stuff.
Amazing.
You're welcome back anytime, kids. God bless.
Thank you.
Let's have a holiday, shall we? Bit of Madonna. Yeah.